we've still been getting used to this.
Rolling! Slate, please. State your name and spell it.
Hi, I am Taylor Hay. It's T as in Tammy, A as in apple, Y as in yellow, L as in lemon, O as in orange, R as in red, and then Hay as H as in horse, A as in apple, Y as in yellow. I can sign that for you if you want as well.
Are we selling product?
I guess so. Trader Joe's sparkling lemon mineral water.
Why should I recycle that bottle?
You should recycle this bottle because if you don't, and if it just goes in the landfill, that means it is going into our soil and it's not biodegradable. Therefore, it will just forever be there, which will eventually pretty much just go into our like waterways. And that's not a good thing because we have miles and miles of waste such as that in our waterways and our oceans that have created this.
Why is that a big problem going on my car window?
Because it's not biodegradable.
Yeah, but it'll just wash down the drain.
The drain goes to our ocean or lakes or ponds, and if it goes into our ocean, there'll be no water for fish to be able to swim in because it'll just compact all together. And I mean, like I said, there's miles and miles of stuff like this and bottles and cardboard and everything that is not biodegradable in our washways.
Fish don't eat those. They float.
Yeah, but it's still, if there's many of these, say thousands and thousands of these in the water, they're going to compact together and the fish won't have any room to move.
Okay, you don't get it, so here, let me help you with another
problem. What if they eat it?
What if a fish eats this?
That's poisonous, not only for...
Good. Explain why a fish shouldn't have that floating in the water.
To make sure that there's nothing in it. It's poisonous. I mean, it's paper.
What is it?
It's a tobacco.
What's in the paper?
Well, nothing is plain, but styrofoam, I think. I don't know.
No. Take a look at it. Tear it apart. See what that really is.
I don't know what's in
it. I want you to tear it apart.
Is it nicotine?
No, it's not. Tear it apart. It's a filter. It's fiberglass. What would fiberglass do to a fish in its body? Aside from the fact that it'll explode with the water, it'll expand. What happens?
Yeah, and then the fish will eat it, and the fish will literally die because it's fiberglass.
But I want you to hold it up to camera, explain what it is, so some kid who's smoking and throwing a cigarette out the window. This is a cigarette filter. Here's what happens when you carelessly throw it out the window. Here's a bottle cap when you carelessly throw this up. This is your moment of lapse of memory, and here's the ripple effect in the world today of everybody doing exactly what you're just throwing a piece of cigarette out. Good example?
That's what I was at, right? Right here?
Yeah, that's good.
Because this is coming from your generation to your generation. Hey, you know, I see around school, campus, wherever, pick a place. Have you ever seen someone throw that out of a window?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. What does it do? What is it? What does it do?
Ask the camera, though.
I want you to ask these people here. Look down their throat. You recognize this? Something like that.
Do you guys know what this is? Maybe what this is? Well, both of these things are hazardous to our environment. This is a cigarette filter. This is a bottle cap. I mean, you may be driving down a freeway or a road or even on campus and just throw these. Or if one of these pops off your drink, you may think, I don't need it anymore. But these are crucial to what is happening to our environment. These two are just a handful of things that are getting thrown into our waterways, and fish eat these and they expand and the fish die. They ingest these, they can't function and they can't digest this, therefore they die. Everything comes down to these little aspects that you guys are throwing into our environment that can't be, is not naturally selected to be in our environment. These aren't supposed to be there. But because you guys just carelessly throw them out the windows, they're there. And now my generation and upcoming generations have to deal with the consequences because your carelessness of throwing these out the window. It's not fair. I'm sorry, but it's not. And I don't think we should have issues, and the asthmatics of the world should have issues because you guys are too lazy to properly dispose of these. I don't think that's fair to us or upcoming generations.
You just gave me an idea, and it's not something I had thought about until just now. And the idea is, we should start a section on the site. Something in the vein of what she just did. And maybe we call them. And they can be like anywhere from 10, 15, 30, 60, 90 seconds. Vignettes people can submit to us from around the world. And we'll put up their stories about Maratus, Rainforest Should Not Die, public service announcements. And we're giving people a platform to make their message be heard to the world at large. I don't care if we get a million of those videos up, it'll make a big website.
Even if it's just
iPhone. Yeah, we just rotate them. Yeah, rotate.
But it'll also get people to know. We can archive, believe me. Storage for me is not a problem. I would rather have a million than...
Isn't it easier to have them posted on...
But let me finish my thought. Please let me finish my thought. Please. Because I lose them really quickly if we keep interrupting them. Then we can also offer them to, like NBC and other stations, they can lift them and put them on broadcast as public service announcements that cross-promote the film. So the thing, we maybe put rules up on the site, they cross-promote the film, they have to give the URL, their name, any pitch they want to give. If we like it, we'll put it on the site. If we don't like it, they can put it on their social media. They can still put it on their social media. They can link to us if they put it up. It makes the whole thing more viral. So I want you to kick off this whole thing, and maybe you'll do one also. What's your name? And I'd like you to help out our film. We're at this rainforestshouldnotdie.com. Keep coming here for information, share with your friends. Hey, I want to share a little tip with you about public service announcement, about how these silly things should be so toxic. Maybe that's the quick short pitch if you're doing like a 90-second or a 30-second. These are toxic. While it may seem like a cigarette butt, and that's toxic unto itself, throwing it out is toxic, throwing this out is toxic, something as simple as a bottle cap can kill.
Do you want me to pitch it as, I want you guys to go around your town and just film just 30-second videos of what you guys
do? No, don't
pitch the video, just do your own
video.
Just do
my own
thing,
yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. Oh God, I have this mess, that's cool.
And I mean, I think that's a great approach to say, see this, it's a filter. See this, it's a bottle cap. These can kill. Those are powerful words.
Yeah.
These can kill.
It's maratusrainforest.com or...
Maratusrainforest should not die.
Shouldnotdie.com.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm having a Charlie horse in my back that is killing me right now. Go ahead, I'll try not to moan too loud.
You see these two things? These are deadly. These can kill you. Not only our generation, but the generations to come. They may just seem like a cigarette butt or a bottle cap, but they can kill you. Just as easily as a normal cigarette can kill you, the butt can kill you if you just throw it out into the street. Or if you just drop one of these because it just spun off your soda. No matter what, they're totally different things, but they both can kill you.
But you have to say that it went into the ocean, and you got to kill, maybe overkill, Kilroy.
It doesn't kill them.
It doesn't kill them.
It kills the fish. It kills the
cigarette. The cigarette can kill us, but the more long-term ripple effect is it starts to kill other people in the food chain, like fish dying. And then when other fish die that may depend on those fish, then other fish die, and fish we depend on may, you know. So it affects the whole food chain. These two little things not only may kill you if a baby chokes on it or you die of cancer, but it affects the whole food chain when you throw it out the window.
Yeah.
Because throwing it out the window means...
Yeah, a fish can die.
Yeah.
A dog can die.
Got it.
You
know?
A squirrel can die.
What if she closes with, to save the planet, visit, and then gives the website?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or...
To help us.
To help us, let's get the world aware.
Do a bridge so that you have an action item.
So we can do a pickup on what you did and do that and then just do a straight clean pickup.
Hold them up for me just so I can get a close up.
The next couple, I've got to go out and stretch.
Okay.
I'm having And if I don't get back in time, then have her do a promo, kind of like Elta Reed did, but shorter.
Okay, put them up
website,
like this.
And then ask her a series of questions like I did last time. I need to take a break.
Yeah,
thanks.
Bring it back.
Just exhausted.
And do it out one more time. And back. Okay. Ready? Are you going?
Let me just clear set and WTA will be in. They will direct each other. You'll be in great hands. I'll be back before you're done. I promise.
Ready? Actually, I want to do this tighter. Okay. Make for the siren. Okay. And action.
Actions such as carelessly throwing these out the window not only can affect us, but they go into our waterways, therefore affecting the fish. And then the animals that live on fish to feed on, they die as well. So not only are you affecting the fish, you're affecting the bears, the wild dogs, all of those mammals that rely on fish. And then you have just normal bacteria and algae in the ocean whose waters are now polluted, therefore they die. And then you have the larger animals that may feed on bears, like the vultures. When the bears die, then they're not going to have food because the food chain just keeps rippling down because of these two things. You may think these as a cigarette filter and a bottle cap. What harm can they do? Well, if you really think about it, these get passed down the food chain, slowly killing every animal that they reach. To find out more about how to help our environment, check out www.maratasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.
Give me the tag again.
To find out more on how to help our environment, check out maratasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.
I need it all together. Stand by. And go.
To find out more how to save our environment, check out maratasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.
You know how to spell that? Oh, it'll be on the screen.
Okay. Your spot was actually the very last half of that. The very last part of that where you said, see this? Yeah. That's the spot.
Yeah.
The whole beginning was like
yeah,
a waste of time.
Okay, ready? One more time.
One more time. And just be very succinct. Start out. This is this.
Yeah. Okay. You can't go into the fish and the bear and the dog and the...
Until you tell us what that is.
Okay. This is a cigarette filter. This is a bottle cap. Now, what can these things do?
Start again.
This is a cigarette filter. This is a bottle cap. Now you may ask yourself, how do these affect our environment? Well, when you throw this out the window, or if you leave these laying around campus or school or wherever you may visit, they get trapped in our waterways. Therefore, the fish end up eating them and the fish die.
The sewer pickup, they get trapped in our waterways and they eventually make it to the ocean where the fish ingest it. And now we're killing our fish.
Okay. These end up making it to our waterways and then slowly go to the ocean. And then in the ocean, the fish ingest it, which means we're slowly killing our fish. Then from there, the animals that feed on fish no longer have that source. So we are pretty much killing every animal in our environment because of these two things. These things are deadly not only to us, but to the entire world around us.
One more time.
These things are not only deadly to us, but they're deadly to the entire world around us. To find out more how to save our planet, check out maratasforestshouldnotdie.com.
One more time.
Rainforest.
To find out more how to save our planet, check out maratasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.
Good.
Can't talk today.
I know, you're still in love yourself. Do you need more for like the talking head soundbite part of
well,
it?
Well, he hasn't done, I'm pretty sure he wants to do the whole part of, here, you can give me those.
I could sum it up.
Yeah. He wants you to talk about, first of all, how the UN has now not supporting the film. The other action items he's been talking about is the loss of species in the rainforest because we're cutting it down, and so we don't have the things that can heal people from diseases like leukemia.
Yeah, I'm actually going to focus a lot on that.
You're going to focus
a lot
on
of research.
I'll okay. touch on it, but I'm not going to.
Yeah, I'm going to focus.
All right. So, what's your favorite hot topic? Air.
Yeah.
I mean, water. Focus on the water.
Focus on the water.
Okay. Yeah. Because, I mean, you live in, you know, I live in California.
The drought.
They're saying, you know, everyone has to cut back on water. Well, here we have at our fingertips a global solution, and we're cutting it down.
Yeah. I mean, the water drives from the rainforest because the clouds pick up the water from the trees.
Yeah. Well, and it's the world's largest producer of water.
Yeah.
Right. People don't know that fresh water...
That's why it's called the rainforest.
That's right. People don't know that water comes out of the rainforest, even though it's called the rainforest.
The rainforest. Yeah, they think it's like ocean. Well, that's
right.
True.
Well, so
yeah.
Even that statement right there is
yeah.
a fun one.
Yeah.
People don't think,
yeah.
which will make them think.
Sure.
It's you're psychologically telling them to think. Okay. So try that.
How many of you think that water comes out of rainforest? I mean, the name is rainforest. I mean, people don't think that water may come out of rainforests. They think, oh, it's going to come out of the ocean. Well, rainforests are the leading provider of water and rain that encompass our earth. I mean, I live in California, and I know that we don't get enough rain. I mean, we're in a drought. But if we chop down all the rainforests, which create the water and the rain, other states will also go into drought. And the entire world will, because there's not enough rain, and there won't be enough water to allow us to have that atmospheric pressure of water come down on us. And we can't live without water. I mean, it's a basic fact. You can't live without food, and you can't live without water. So where will we get the water if we cut down all the rainforests?
It's a fair question. Let's just say that last sentence again.
Okay. If we cut down all our rainforests, where are we going to get all our water?
Good.
How do you feel about the UN pulling out of the film?
How do I feel about the UN pulling their support out of the film?
Start again.
How do I feel about the UN pulling out their support from the film? I think it's incredibly fishy. I mean, we are exposing this nationwide and this worldwide problem, and they had our backs, and now we're actually digging deep and undiscovering these problems and these truths behind all this, they all of a sudden pull their support from us. I think something else is going on there. I don't think that's...
Yeah, I don't think you can use the word fishy, personally.
Yeah,
yeah.
I don't use fishy.
Because it's fishy. Okay. So think of the word you're going to use before you get there.
I would use the irony. You know, here's an organization that's
right.
dedicated to saving our planet who suddenly pull their support on
right.
a film that is educating us to save our planet.
Right.
How does that make sense? And that you're not throwing any accusations,
yeah.
you're just posing a question.
And the figure of speech in your delivery would be to say, isn't that ironic? Because
yeah.
you're putting an exclamation point on the irony of it.
Yeah. The UN pulling the support out of this project, I feel like it's ironic. I mean, a group set out to help the environment, to help change and help save our natural resources, are now pulling their support from a film that is trying to get that word out, is trying to get other people to realize this is what's going on. I just feel like it's insanely ironic that a group known for trying to support the rainforest and support natural resources pulled out on a film that is making it known to everybody what the truth and what the reality of our rainforests are.
Pose the question.
Why is the UN pulling out?
Why could that be?
Okay. Yeah.
What possible reason could they have for doing that?
Okay.
You have a flyaway on this slide. There you go. That's good.
So just pick it up from that, or?
Yeah, just ask it as an independent question.
Why is the UN removing their support from this film?
Ironic, isn't it? Fate altogether.
Why is the UN removing their support from this film? Ironic, isn't it?
That's great.
What other hot points has he had?
We're talking about 2 degrees or 5 years. So if the overall temperature of the country, of the world, increases by 2 degrees globally, it's like, that's the, you know, pull the plug thing.
Yeah, or
scientifically.
I kind of know the truth of that.
Yeah,
though.
Scientifically, it's massive. There would have to be massive changes to increase.
I mean, I'm in a bio class. And literally,
you asked me.
I mean, she's taking science right
yeah.
now.
It would
she
be
might not be the best one to
like,
ask that.
It'd be the equivalent of a gajillion. What's the word I'm looking for?
Joules?
No, a gajillion.
Like atomic blast or
not
something.
Atomic
what did
blast.
You say? She told me.
Solar flares.
Solar flares.
It'd be like a gajillion solar flares.
To increase by 2.
Yeah.
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 It's.
I don't shoot the messenger.
I'm
just,
I'm not,
you
no,
asked,
no.
I'm just...
Just saying, I might not be the best one to ask that question.
Yeah, we want facts. We want good facts.
Yeah.
What is happening to the number of species?
There you go. Dale, talk about the people who live there. I don't think a lot of people know that.
Okay.
That's a good idea. How is it impacting them?
Well, there's actually
a
tribe.
What's that group called?
I don't remember. Just say there's an indigenous tribe.
Okay. There's an indigenous tribe that lives in the Muratos rainforest. This tribe has been there for hundreds of thousands of years.
Not 3,000 years.
That was hundreds of thousands.
3,000.
So 3,000?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, there's other tribes that have been there, though,
yeah.
that we've been, yeah, we've been researching so much that it's just like everything runs together. There's this indigenous tribe that lives in the Muratos rainforest. This specific tribe has been there for 3,000 years. They immigrated over from Asia, and what they've been doing is they rotate. They plant their crops and they rotate so they don't pose an effect and they don't pose a problem on the rainforest itself. They lived there for 3,000 years and they haven't caused an issue. But now by them deforesting that area, this tribe is almost going extinct. They're killing off the native homeland for this tribe. They're killing off the resources and the food and the medicine and the plants and the trees and the animals that they live on. How is that fair? That'd be like going to us and taking away our food source and killing us off. That's pretty much what these companies are doing to this one tribe in the Muratos rainforest.
Just as a soundbite overlay, say big business. is killing off these tribes.
And the endangered orangutan.
Big businesses are killing off this indigenous tribe. And also, there's an endangered orangutan that lives in the Muratos rainforest, but they don't seem to care about that. I mean, it's endangered. You think of other endangered animals, and they're under special care. Why not this orangutan? Why are they killing the only home that it has?
What do they call? What does Kirk call it? Does he call the people who are actually farming the wood out of the forest?
The Dayaks tribe.
What is? I don't. Forgive me for not knowing, but what's the name of business that goes in and takes down the rainforest? Does he call them something?
Logging companies.
There's the, well. There are many companies that are involved in deforestation. You named several.
There's logging companies, there's coal.
They're actually allowing people to go in and capture the birds and sell them off to bird traders.
They just need to come to Pasadena. They can get as many, you know, little birds as they want. The parrots got loose and they started breeding. So there are hundreds of them.
Oh, my Lord.
And there's no...
there's no way to control
it. There's no way to control it. There's no other animal that will eat them, so they're literally
running amok.
Yes. Okay, so you're gonna the tribe. Want to just say the tribe name, kind of blend that in.
Dayaks.
Make it personal. There's this small tribe. Somehow make it human. Make it, you know, instead of them being over there in a way that doesn't make it like I care.
Yeah.
Make it so I care.
Okay.
Imagine, you know, imagine a tribe, a whole small nation, you know, of people, unlike anybody else, who live in the rainforest. Now I'm listening because you're talking. Now I can identify with a group of people that are different than anybody else on the planet.
Okay.
Is it the Dayaks?
I'm looking.
Pretty sure it is.
All right. Here, let's try it with that.
Can you hear that?
Dayak. Can you hear him?
Yeah, I can hear him. He doesn't care.
Kurt, be quiet.
Shut up.
Filming, darling.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Ready? Imagine. Go ahead.
There's a small tribe called the Dayak tribe that lives in the Marathas rainforest. Now, this tribe is unlike any other group of people out there. I mean, not only are they now going extinct, but they found a way to live in the rainforest for 3,000 years without affecting it in any way. Now, when you look at us, we're throwing stuff into the water rays and we're carelessly throwing away our planet. But they've lived in the same spot for 3,000 years without affecting it at all. They're growing their own food. They're finding their own plants for medicine. They're literally living in this small portion of the rainforest that's slowly getting smaller and smaller and smaller. And pretty soon, they're going to be gone. And there's going to be no other memory of the Dayak tribe.
That's sad. Okay.
How about your problems?
No, I'm not using.
Step forward. Just take a step forward. There you go. Actually, take a little bitty step back. Good. Just check the microphone. And stop and